Well, my mother was a big movie fan. And, well, for example, when I was born, she was pregnant, but she wanted to go out and see movies. And on this particular day, she just wanted to see two movies in a row. And then the second one was Japanese samurai movies. And then I sort of started crying out inside her, you know, body. Yes, I want to see, I want to see. And then I was born. So from that moment after, I'm, you know, becoming a movie fan.
Masato Harada, quien también, gracias a su madre, conoció a Akira Kurosawa en el set de filmación de Los Siete Samuráis, siempre ha sido un apasionado de la historia y llevó a la pantalla grande el fin de la Segunda Guerra Mundial desde la intimidad del Palacio Imperial.
The Emperor in August is the first time in Japanese cinema that we showed the Emperor in close-ups and sort of in private talk or anything. I always wanted to make something about this, how the war ended in 1945, August in 1945, because if the war continued for another week, and if the Allied forces attacked southern part of Japan, my father would have been killed as one of the first battles. Starting the war, breaking out the war, it's easy in a way. But how to stop it is the most difficult task. That's what I wanted to show. These three characters, Hirohito, Suzuki, and General Anami, and three of them together, got together, and that's how the war ended. So I needed to show that, I wanted to share that kind of notion with some other audiences, and particularly Japanese audience.
この日本という国を子孫に伝えることである。
But the only problem I had in Japan was I had a problem with film reviewers. I mean, for overseas it's okay, but the Japanese film reviewer, sometimes, well, most of the time, they put ideology before the quality of the film. But I never put ideology before the quality of the film. I mean, impartiality of a position is really important thing for a filmmaker. Don't take political statement or anything at all, but I just wanted to show, as a human being, the emperor as a human being, and the militant officer, this General Anami, as a human being.
El emperador en agosto robaría la atención del público japonés, pero también cautivaría al embajador de México en Japón, Carlos Almada, quien invitó a Harada a la embajada.
He asked me about this Kumaichi Horiguchi, and have you ever heard of this Kumaichi Horiguchi? I said no, and then he showed me the plaque of the how Mexican government thanked him for saving the lives of Madero's family, and I was just fascinated by that. This Horiguchi, father and son involvement in Mexican Revolution, it's another interesting subject matter. So everything started from there.
Harada sería cautivado ahora por la historia del diplomático japonés Hiroguchi, quien mostró su valentía durante la decena trágica al proteger en la legación japonesa a la familia de Francisco y Madero. Este acto de amistad entre México y Japón es la base del nuevo proyecto cinematográfico de Harada.
And it should be Mexican-Japanese co-production, but probably I'll bring the minimum number of crew members from Japan. But to me, it's the most important factor at this point is the locations. I make films, but I don't fall in love with the actors, but I fall in love with the locations. In order to keep the, you know, this space of Chapultepec Castle, and this national palace, then I think about the episode and incorporate into screenplay, and I keep making films that way.
その場合、陛下のお助けをお願いいたします。